leave the physical world altogether? Most cultures believe the power to be everywhere, see everything, is reserved only for the gods. The ancient Egyptians represented their god Horus as an all-seeing eye, a symbol that came down into the Judeo-Christian world. But in Hindu tradition, the third eye of Shiva has become a mark for ordinary mortals. Hindus believe that there is no distinction between self and the universe. Those who have become enlightened can learn to transcend their physical surroundings. For centuries, shamans of the nomadic tribes of Central Asia claimed that when they went into trance states, their spirit bodies could travel to faraway places. In the 1930s, Dr. Joseph Rhine began a series of scientific experiments to test whether this mind's eye might be real. In his most famous trial, he asked a subject to predict the order of unseen cards from 100 yards away. He claimed the subject's guesses were twice as good as random chance. Rhine repeated the experiment from a distance of 250 yards, and again the subject predicted an order well above chance. After several years of research and testing, Dr. Rhine came to the conclusion that this sixth sense ability was real and named it ESP, extrasensory perception. This is David Morehouse. 20 years ago, he was a spy for the United States military. But he wasn't reading maps or satellite photos to gather intelligence. He was using ESP. His journey into the world of psychic spying began after a near-fatal incident.
In 1987, I was a Ranger Company commander. It was my second company command. And my company was selected to go to the Kingdom of Jordan to train Jordanian Rangers. While I was there training, I was wounded in the head by a stray Jordanian machine gun bullet. It knocked me unconscious on the desert floor, and I had a vision in this kind of in-between state, between consciousness and unconsciousness, kind of a dream state. Most people that have these kinds of nightmares visions are reluctant to talk about them. It's not easy to sit down and say, I'm now shifted in some way. Some portal is open and something is pouring in that I'm not aware of.
But what Morehouse didn't know is that 10 years earlier, the US military had contracted two laser physicists, Russell Targ and Harold Puthoff, to test the applications of ESP. In the midst of the Cold War, the US military was searching for new ways to gather intelligence on the Soviet Union.
The US government was looking for ways that they might enhance human performance potentials, to try to use the human mind to essentially see the battlefield, to watch the battle unfold before it ever occurred.
It was a technique called remote viewing. The psychic spy would sit in a room closed off from the outside world, be given coordinates of a target, and asked to describe what they saw. Early experiments yielded stunning results. One of the more remarkable was by Pat Price, a former police commissioner from Burbank, California. He was instructed to remote view a secret Soviet military facility and report his findings. He drew this large gantry crane that had 8 wheels and rolled along tracks. He also sketched these gas cylinders. This is a drawing from the actual satellite photo of the Soviet facility. The drawing reveals significant similarities to Pat Price's viewing session, including the number of wheels on the gantry. It was a stunning achievement in remote viewing. As a result of these findings, the government began recruiting psychic spies to participate in the remote viewing program, and David Morehouse was one of them.
It was bizarre to come from the physical world of being an infantry company commander to entering this metaphysical world of being a remote viewer.
David Morehouse was sent to a top secret facility to see if he could tap into his sixth sense. In 1988, David Morehouse was sent to Fort Meade, Maryland to become a remote viewer. To evaluate David's remote viewing ability, the CIA gave him a random test target. It was the Library of Congress. But all David had to connect with the target was a set of encrypted coordinates. He first drew an abstract line and then recorded sensory data like colors, textures, temperatures, and smells. Information from David's subconscious now began filling the pages. Black, white, red, blue, glass, metal, books, magazines, marble.
Now all of a sudden, boom, another sketch, another full image comes to mind. So I now sketch this one, which has that dome.
The sketch was a remarkable hit, but Morehouse kept on going. More information fills in the puzzle. Archives, Bill of Rights, Congress, Constitution. At the end of the session, this was his summary of the hidden target. Government building having protected historical documents significant to the people and their heritage.
It was a good session for a brand new remote viewer at that point in time. I was at this stage deemed operational.
It seems like an impossible strike in the dark, but the CIA's goal was to ensure remote viewers gave them consistently good results. Morehouse helped clarify the rules that made remote viewing a learnable skill.
Anyone could do it. There would certainly be some people who were better at it than others, but anyone could learn to do it, to unlock this potential.
According to the protocols, the viewer first retrieves sensory information and records it on paper in the form of words and sketches. At the learning stage, the viewer sits in a chair at a table with paper and pens in front of them. An observer is in the room. Outside stimuli are shut off. At more advanced levels, a viewer might decide to lie down, listen to music, or use a blindfold to achieve a deeper state of consciousness. The most successful viewers seem to be able to develop the ability to bilocate, or be at two places at the same time.
Bilocation is really when the viewer's physical body begins to manifest the physiological indicators of what the viewer is experiencing in the target site. So let's say, for example, that a viewer is looking at missile silos in Siberia at sub-zero temperatures. Well, the viewer sees themselves in this target, and all of a sudden the viewer, their skin temperature begins to drop and their body's core temperature begins to drop. That's called a bilocation. And when you start to bilocate, now you know you have arrived as a viewer.
Although most of his missions were classified, Morehouse remote viewed South American drug lords and kidnapped American VIPs. But the deeper David got into the program, the more emotionally challenging it became.
To be in some of your training targets and to sense the emotional, overwhelming emotional stain of a place like Dachau. To step into the mind of some military dictator someplace, or even some drug trafficker. All of those things have a cumulative toll on human psyche.
After 3 years as a remote viewer, David quit the program. He'd gone from being someone who never thought about a sixth sense to someone for whom ESP was so real that it became overwhelmingly painful.
An understanding of what was really going on in you was not important. What was more important was utilizing you as a tool to collect information on the real or perceived enemies of your nation.
Despite the emotional distress David experienced as a remote viewer, he now realizes he is armed with a powerful mind-altering tool.
Undeniably knowing that there's something beyond the physical in your life and that you are part of it and connected to it all the time. That's a very powerful stance to take in this life, and remote viewing is one of the tools that will help get you there.